Instead of the worst-case scenario that Vice President Sara Duterte supposedly heard of, lawmakers recommended what they believed to be a fair appropriation for the office of the Vice President. A lawmaker cited several reasons why the lower house committee arrived at such a decision. Mela Lesmoras tells us more.
After thorough study and careful consideration, the House Committee on Appropriations has recommended to reduce the 2025 budget proposal of the Office of the Vice President. From the original allocation of 2 billion pesos, more than 1 billion pesos was slashed for a total of 733 million pesos and close to the amount her predecessor received when she was in office. According to Appropriations Panel Senior Vice Chair Stella Kimbo, there were two main reasons why they recommended the budget cut. First, they found out that there are redundant social programs or initiatives that are already being implemented by the national government agencies, which the OVP just duplicated. That's why they want to transfer these specific funds to the DOH and DSWD. Second, they also identified the OVP has too many satellite offices, which they claim are apparently unnecessary and needlessly adds to the vice president's budget. But some are wondering, did the OVP's recent boycott of the budget hearing also influence the committee's decision?
Trabaho lang pong ginagawa natin. At the end of the day, the most important thing to us would be the information needed to reflect on the budget. Yun lang talaga. So, to the extent na yung absence niya did not shed light on many issues, yun sa aking palagay ang naka-affect. Yung kakulangan ng information.
But then Kimbo clarified their recommendation is not yet final as it will still go through the House plenary along with other processes. If approved, she assured, however, the personnel services or the OVP staff and their salaries will not be affected by the budget cut. Meanwhile, House Deputy Minority Leader Franz Castro said the 10 million pesos budget for VP Sara's book Isang Kaibigan should also be transferred to DepEd to support their educational initiatives. As of now, the OVP has yet to release any statement on this latest development on her office's budget request, but Vice President Duterte already expressed readiness to go on even if the Congress decides to completely defund her office next year. Meanwhile, amid the issue, Senate President Francis Escudero urges heads of agencies to respect and go through the budget process and let Congress do its job. The Senate President is also hopeful these issues will be resolved soon. For Senator Sherwin Gatchalian,
kawawa naman yung mga empleyado nila at dahil mayroong mga empleyado ang Office of the Vice President, kailangan sila sumweldo, kailangan rin ng benefits para sa kanila. So, kawawa naman yung mga empleyado nagtatrabaho dito. So, yan ang effect kung isi-zero budget nila.
Next week, the House of Representatives is set to commence its plenary debates on the proposed 2025 national budget. Mela Lesmoras from the National TV Network for a new and better Philippines.